conflict is the driving force behind all stories. It can be external, as in between a character and their opponent, or internal, as in between a character and themselves. Both are necessary building blocks for a good narrative, but it is the latter one that allows the audience to experience the world through the character's eyes. A man picking up a bottle of vodka makes for a simple scene. A recovering alcoholic doing the same makes for drama. Alcoholism is also the main vice of Captain Whittaker, the protagonist of Robert Zemeckis' 2012 film Flight. Whittaker is a miserable airline pilot who seeks solace in his heavy substance abuse. He is still under the influence from the night before when his plane suddenly breaks mid-air and sends itself spiraling towards the ground. Whittaker manages to perform an emergency landing and is hailed as a hero, but loses his girlfriend in the crash. Not only that, but his positive touchscreen also makes him a central focus in a subsequent NTSB investigation into the incident. Whittaker's actions in the film are dubious to say the least, but through focusing the narrative on his strong internal conflict, writer John Gattens makes us root for him rather than despise him. Welcome to a writing lesson of Flight and the Burden of Internal Conflict. In his book Anatomy of Story, John Truby discusses a character's internal and external conflict as their need and desire. Truby says that need has to do with overcoming a weakness within the character, whereas desire is a goal outside of the character. In the case of Captain Whittaker, his primary desire seems simple enough. He wants to lie his way out of ending up in prison. His need, on the other hand, is a bit more complicated. He needs to stop drinking, and by extension to stop lying and manipulating so that he may win back his happiness. Throughout the second act, Whittaker shows a constant desire to act on his need, but in a brilliant bit of storytelling, is unable to do so because of his current predicament. Changing his ways right now would mean that he end up in prison with no guarantee of ever being reunited with his family, so he has no choice but to keep on lying. Despite the aftermath of the plane crash serving as the central plot of the movie, the tension deriving from Captain Whittaker's inner conflict is what drives it all the way until the end. But not in the way you'd expect. Flight is built around a two-part climax where Captain Whittaker first achieves and loses his desire before finally fulfilling his need. By the end of Act 2, Whip has actually gotten sober and is getting ready for the upcoming NTSB hearing. He's checked into an overnight hotel where, unable to sleep, begins roaming around the rooms and runs into a refrigerator filled with alcohol. In a scene that is arguably more nerve-wracking than the opening plane crash itself, he takes out a bottle of vodka and holds it in his hand like a man contemplating suicide. For the audience, the choice here seems simple. All Captain Whittaker has to do is to not drink, right? But the character is yet to have his moment of self-revelation. The self-revelation, as defined by Truby, is the point where the hero strips away the facade that he has lived behind and sees himself honestly for the first time. It is the most courageous act that the character can perform, and after they've done so, their need will finally be fulfilled. But Whittaker's need is not fulfilled. He hasn't confessed to his faults, he's merely managed to keep them in check so that he can fulfill his temporary desire. And in this moment, despite what seems to be the obvious, Whittaker's need to embrace his alcoholism once again overcomes his desire to stay sober. He can't stop drinking, not until he acknowledges this fundamental truth about himself. The scene immediately following has been brilliantly engineered to put the audience in Whittaker's shoes. We now know that he'll never be strong enough to stop drinking without addressing his need, but we still don't want to see him end up in prison. In order to make it out of this, we want Whittaker to commit the ultimate crime against his need in order to achieve his temporary desire. Not only do we want him to lie under oath, but we also need him to take narcotics in order to be able to do so. But Whittaker refuses. He begins the hearing by responding to the questions dishonestly, but when he's presented by one that he knows would tarnish the memory of his deceased girlfriend, he finally has his moment of self-revelation. He confesses to criminal negligence as well as alcoholism and is sent to prison. He sacrifices his desire in favor of his need for the first time and is willing to pay the price for it. It's a mark of particularly strong writing when the protagonist ends up in prison and yet, somehow, the audience is left feeling like he's won. So what lesson should we take from this? Well, while external conflict can certainly determine a film's popcorn value, it is internal conflict that will determine whether or not they leave the screening with something more than just entertainment. Flight is a masterclass in internal struggle as it makes its protagonist's personal demons the main source of conflict. All action that Captain Whittaker takes in the story, no matter how despicable, is motivated by a deeper need to defeat himself, and it makes us invest 110%. By putting this internal struggle at the forefront of his screenplay and prioritizing Whitaker's need over his desire, writer John Gattins has offered the audience a lens through which they can sincerely root for the salvation of this seemingly unredeemable character.